Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2214. Really annoying VBA bug when you're trying to insert a picture. All right, so hey, this started happening in Excel 2010. I just got burnt by it again recently. So I'm going to insert a picture in this workbook, but I want to record that action so I can automatically do it. View, macros, record a macro, how to insert picture. Perfect. And I'm just going to insert a picture here. Illustrations, pictures. Let's choose one of our rocket photos and insert. All right, stop recording. Beautiful. Now I'm going to get rid of that. We're going to take a look at the macro. So Alt F8, how to insert a picture, edit. And it says it's this ActiveSheet.Pictures.Insert, and then the path to the picture. All right, that sounds good. And in fact, we should be able to run this. So Alt F8, how to insert a picture, and run, and we get the picture. That's beautiful. Until I save this workbook and let you download it or send it to someone else, and then the picture doesn't show up at all. All I get is a red X saying, hey, we can't find the picture anymore. Like, what do you mean you can't find the picture? I asked you to insert a picture, not a link to the picture, but starting in Excel 2010, this recorded code is actually inserting a link to the picture. And if I open this workbook somewhere on a computer that doesn't have access to this drive and that picture, red X. Super annoying. All right, so for some reason, Excel 2010, the new thing to do is instead of ActiveSheet.Pictures.Insert, you have to do ActiveSheet.Shapes.AddPicture. All right, and we can still specify a file name, but then these extra arguments that we have, link to file, false, in other words, don't create the stupid red link, and then save with document, true, which means actually put the darn picture in there, and then you can specify where it's supposed to be, the left and top. Now, how do we figure out the height and the width? All right, well, we want to resize this proportionally, right? So I'm going to hold down the shift key while I get this back to less than one screen full of data. Maybe like that right there. So that's my goal. I want to insert the picture and have it be that size. With that selected, I'll come back to VBA, Alt F11, Control G for the immediate window, and I'll ask for selection.width. So that's question mark space selection.width, and then question mark selection.height. All right, and that tells me about 140 and 195. So the width 140 and 195. Like that, get rid of the immediate window, and then here we'll delete this and run the code, and it actually inserted it. It's the right size. It'll be able to be opened when you download this or I download this if you don't have access to the original picture. I get it. Things change. They had to change the code, but the fact they didn't update the macro recorder, and the macro recorder is giving us the bad code that doesn't work, that's super annoying. Well, hey, to learn more about macros, check out this book, Excel 2016 VBA Macros by Tracy Searstad and myself. We actually have a version of this for every version going back to Excel 2003. So whatever you have, provided it's Windows, there's a version for you. All right, wrap up today. It's my problem. I recorded code to insert a picture, and it's creating a link to the picture, so anyone else I send the workbook to can't see the picture. Instead of using the macro recorder, that does ActiveSheet.Pictures.Insert, use this new ActiveSheet.Shapes.AddPicture, where we can specify link to file, no, save with document, yes, and you'll be good to go. Well, hey, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.